job shouldn't have mattered. I'd killed nobles before. You could float a whaling ship on the highborn blood I've spilled. Another noble steps in to replace the last one. All equally corrupt. Why should an empress be different? But she was. I watched her bodyguard's face as they took him away. Dead eyes. I knew I'd pay for this one. Maybe I deserved to. A storm was coming that would shake apart everything I'd built.
Dowd, my old friend. It's been a long while, but you've got my interest again. How the years pass and the bodies fall. Did you know that there are only 8 like you in the world, bearing my mark? I'm here because you're right. The Empress was different. This time, you can't just fade away into the shadows. There will be consequences. Your story is close to ending, and even you can't escape it. But what ending will you make for yourself? I'm here to give you one last gift, Dowd. It's a mystery. One that starts with a name. Delilah.
For 6 months, the city writhed and changed. For 6 months, I tried to forget what I'd done to the Empress and her little girl. But there was no forgetting. I needed to find my next move. But all I had was that name, Delilah. Who was she? A threat? Or an ally? Word came from my second-in-command, Billy Lurk. In a house built on secrets, Lurk was especially good at uncovering them. There was a ship called the Delilah that hunted whales for Bundry Rothwild. A former deckhand who'd made good. Now he owned a slaughterhouse and he ran his workers like a prison gang. A ship named Delilah. It could be a coincidence, but it's not. In Dunwall, things are always tangled up like a bag of snakes.
Dowd. You're here. I got bored, so I started without you. Turns out we're here on the perfect day. There's a strike at the plant, and it's no wonder. Rothwild runs this place like a prison. The stupid workers can't even get in without a time card. When the strike started, the butchers confiscated all the cards they could find. They've given the City Watch free rein to use force. If you ever wondered why I wanted out of the slums, here's your answer. There'll be other ways in, I'm sure of it. You don't mind if I tag along, right? Just to keep an old man safe. One last thing. I found something for you. I know you collect these. I'll be on the rooftops till you need me.
You up too.
You have to give me back my time card. I can't get back in. No right to take it.
Try and get past me, and I'll see you swinging from a meat hook.
Go home, mister. Orders are to confiscate those cards. No exceptions.
You die weeping, all of you. I hope the plague gets you.
Nice.
Attention. Under plague conditions, failure to report for work at industries deemed vital to state interests has been declared treasonous by the Lord Regent.
There's a man out on the river watching the place. If I weren't so young and pure of heart, I'd suggest he's up to no good.
Think you'll get your own squad after what happened last night? Chances are very good.
Heaven's dice.
They used to tell stories about a woman in the slums who did work like this. Granny Rags. They said she was 100 years old.
Collective bargaining in any industry deemed vital to the state is a capital offense. These include metallurgy, whale collection and refinement, security services, and selected legal and clerical specializations. Consult the city barrister for verification and enforcement.
Sign the contract, and you'll be back at work tomorrow.
They used to tell stories about a woman in the slums who did work like this. Granny Rags. They said she was 100 years old.
When does the oil start to flow again?
It's all fixed, Chief. We got the time cards rounded up, and now we got their melting leader.
So you know, the Regent doesn't give a shit who wins your little labor dispute. The Regent cares about the whale oil.
No, Sketch dies.
Tanks and these damn things don't last long enough.
Do you know the guts off the killing floor?
You better believe it.
Thank you.
whoever you are, and then I'll demonstrate your failing.
Sign the contract, and you'll be back at work tomorrow.
2/3 pay in.
Oh! Damn!
They won't let you in without a time card. But if you get us out of here, you can take mine. I'm not coming back. Open the gate, please. We still need to get past that wall of light contraption they put up. If you can shut it off, we can slip past the city watch when the time is right. Is the wall of light down? Not yet. We can wait. You're all we've got.
After this morning, we're taking away time cards on site. Nobody gets in or out without those things. Time to send a message.
Thank you.
Hans dies.
Is the wall of light down?
You're free to go. Make your way out of this place.
Here's the card, sir. I hope you burn this place to the ground. If you see a woman named Abigail Ames, she'll know what to do. She's a smart cookie.
Rothwild's got a stubborn reputation. I doubt asking nicely is going to work. We'll have to find a more persuasive means of getting what you want out of him. He's probably close to his office. We should start there.
Hey, have you been in the chair already?
Yes, but I signed right away. Mr. Rothwild didn't even have to turn it on.
I don't believe you.
No, it's true.
Is he calling you a liar?
That's what it sounds like. I'm gonna teach you to respect me. That went a little deep. It was only supposed to scare him. Oops.
Well, he did look scared. Just at the end there.
Break's over, looks like.
When's this day gonna end?
Your men, you'll collect your bonuses at sundown in my offices. Well done, my boys. The rest of you piss off.
Wake up, Hilo.
Who is sneaking and snooping? Think I won't find you?
Thank you.
with that. I spotted a makeshift interrogation room in the meat locker. It might be useful to you, considering our mission here.
Striking laborers, my generous offer stands. Half pay in a dozen lashes.
So much, huh?
Marked for shipment to the most distant point of the Empire. And fitted for live cargo, too. Survivable, if they had a fast ship. I wonder who this was meant for. You box somebody up in that thing and they won't be back in town for months.
I'll find you eventually. You ain't leaving this place alive. I ain't stupid. I know you're here. Come on out! I hate skimmers like you. Always sneaking and snooping. Quit biting.
Is a makeshift interrogation chair. Rothwild must be using it to coerce employees.
You better hope I don't find you. You hear me?
Speak up, you pile of offal. Big stupid, I know you're here. Come on out! I'll find you eventually. You ain't leaving this place alive. I ain't stupid. I know you're here. Come on out!
To all striking laborers, my generous offer stands. Pay him a dozen lashes.
This is about fair pay and safe conditions.
Don't bother. You're not the first of his moles I've caught. What happened?
You? Oh no! Well, Dowd, what do you want with me?
I'm not here for you. I'm here to learn about a ship called the Delilah.
Did the Lord Regent send you? That old fool, Hiram Burrows. I know all about the Delilah. All of it. And I can give you exactly what you want.
Please do.
Not so fast. I need something from you in exchange.
That's what I thought. What?
We're both professionals, Mr. Dowd. I was hired to get these gutless workers striking, which I did very nicely. And then destroy the slaughterhouse itself. That's where I got caught. And that's where I need your help.
How?
The whale oil in those tanks out there is enough to destroy this entire place. The important industrial bits, especially. Just open all the valves at once to let the oil start flowing. The pressure will go out of control, and... boom.
What about the people inside?
Growing a conscience? The factory workers are already out. My boss will hire them on, in better conditions than they'd ever see here. Not the butchers, though. They can die screaming for all I care.
Don't try and con me.
Wouldn't dream of it. Here's the key. Don't get caught. You take care of the slaughterhouse, and I'll tell you everything I know about the Delilah.
You know, I could put you in Rothwild's interrogation chair myself. Why should I bargain with you?
Because it's a long and messy solution. And I'm gambling you're not the kind of man who likes that. Make a deal with me, and I can tell you what you want. And pay you for your trouble.
I'll consider it.
I should have hired you to protect her. We'd be living in a different world now.
Time for me to get a promotion. To get a saw.
step.
System in there looks like it will put down that whale in an instant. I almost think you should. I know they're just beasts, but still.
Thank you.
Time is short. Now, about the Delilah.
You're sailing in murky waters, assassin. Now, they say that ship was sold to Rothwild cheap by one of his business partners, a barrister, Arnold Tinch. They'd planned to sell a portion of the whale oil on the black market, instead of giving it to the Lord Regent. Treason. Would that be why you're here?
My reasons are my own. The black market doesn't concern me.
Because that's only half the story. Arnold Timps sold that ship to Rothwild because he was afraid of its namesake. Timps fell in love with a painter named Delilah. It was the scandal of the season. That shrunken old lecher acting like a giddy schoolboy over a nobody. A former serving girl from Dunwall Tower.
Let me guess. It didn't end well.
It never does. But there's a mystery to this one. Something happened that frightened him very much. He dropped her overnight and sold the ship for a quarter of what it's worth. And Barrister Timps is not a man who scares easily. If you want to know more, you'll have to ask him yourself. But I very much doubt he'll tell you.
I guess we're done here. I'll meet you outside.
Pressure in the pipes is past safe levels. All employees.
We're not done yet, assassin.
No,
we're
not.
Someone
get
over to the here. House. Mine will be ours.
What?
I'm out.
Thank you. Let's go. I'm worried they sent for the hounds.
This is your last warning. If you are anywhere in the vicinity of Rothwild Slaughterhouse, get out now.
Should we gather for whiskey and cigar? Tonight, never doubt it.
Huh? By the outsider! Someone get over here!
Is anything bothering you, Dowd? I've seen you kill a man without ruffling his hair. You took out the whole neighborhood. Barrister Timsh lives up in the legal district. I know it pretty well. From what I hear, the Timsh family is practically at war with itself. Talk to his niece Tali if you can. I should probably tag along when you go. Crazy rich people are buying up a lot of that Sokolov security technology these days. Keeps the weepers and looters out. I might be useful.
Let's go.
Oh, I'll find you. It looked like he just